Welcome to episode 35. This is about how the yellow fever epidemic in Buenos Aires, Argentina, helped start Tango. If you're watching a short, be sure to click on the link below. And this is also sponsored by SONOSTICS.com, which makes a medical device, which is external. You put it under your feet, and it helps a muscle pump blood back to the heart and improves your cognitive health. It actually can reverse cognitive decline and bring you back to normal, this machine. It's an external medical device. Very cool. Okay, so what happened was there's a river in Argentina that was the port, the original port, and it dead ends in a place called Boca, which means mouth, because it's not a flowing river. It only flows when it rains, basically. And this is where the port of Argentina was. And next to the port was a wealthy neighborhood called San Telmo, where the wealthy people lived. But wealth can't protect you from mosquitoes. And they had a lot of mosquitoes when there were floods, and people were getting yellow fever, and they were dying, right? So what happened was, Dr. Guillermo Rawson of the Hospital Rawson was a public health doctor, and he said, you have to move. And so the wealthy people, they got on a bus or transportation of some kind, and they went from the Rawson Hospital up to the hills north of San Telmo in a place called Recoleta. And they moved there, and they built new houses there, new mansions. They abandoned their original mansions, their old mansions in San Telmo. And San Telmo was an unhealthy place to live, and so was Boca. So what happened was, and unfortunately, Dr. Rawson's brother, Franklin Rawson, named after Benjamin Franklin, because the Rawsons originally came from Boston, Massachusetts, before they immigrated to Argentina because the American Revolution. Franklin had to stay with the artists because they don't have any money. They're poor. So he stayed in Dr. Guillermo Rawson's house, mansion, in San Telmo, and he died from yellow fever. Very sad. So what happened was, there's a bus even today. It's bus number 67, and it says on the bus, from Rawson Hospital to Recoleta. And that is the route that these wealthy people took. And they went to Recoleta and founded a new city. And between Recoleta and San Telmo, there was a city called Buenos Aires, fresh air, right? Without mosquitoes. That's how Buenos Aires, I think, got its name. It means fresh air in Spanish. So what happened, the original government of Argentina, the elected government, was in San Telmo. There was no Buenos Aires. But Buenos Aires began to become a city between Recoleta in the north and San Telmo in the south. And what happened is the houses were abandoned in San Telmo, and so the poor people moved in. And these were beautiful mansions. They had spiral staircases, chandeliers, everything. Upstairs, ballrooms. And the poor people, smart, they turned them into bordellos. So Argentina had the best bordellos in the world in these mansions. And what would happen is if you go to the bordello, the woman would ask you to dance. And then she would decide whether she wanted to go with you. So the women selected the men. From the street, they did that, and because they were smart girls. They know all men have the same amount of money, so they get to choose who they want. And then they started doing it in these mansions. And so this led to the expansion of tango dancing indoors. It started on the streets in Dorrego Plaza, which is right next to Dr. Guillermo Rawson's mansion, which is on Umberto Primo Street. And he let them come into the hospital and dance in the hospital for free on Sundays. They'd bring food and wine, the poor people, and they'd stay out of the rain. But then when these mansions became available, they started going over there, but they were basically bordellos, these mansions. So tango grew bigger and better with the help of Dr. Rawson forming Practico Rawson, which is the first indoor tango in the world. At the hospital, and then after that, the mansions became available to the poor people, and they moved in and took over these abandoned mansions. And in Recoleta, people built bigger houses, bigger mansions. And then I'll tell you more. I went to Recoleta, and there's a famous cemetery there. And around this cemetery in Recoleta are all the wonderful coffee shops and sidewalk cafes. So it's a very famous area. You sit there around the cemetery. And I was sitting there having a cup of coffee, and I said, you know, I'm going to go into the cemetery and see if I can find Dr. Rawson, because he's probably there. Because Juan Perón is in the cemetery at Recoleta. So I found Juan Perón, but Juan Perón was in the suburbs. Right? I found out, I asked a security guard, I said, where is Dr. Guillermo Rawson? He's here or someplace, I think. And I found Juan Perón, but I don't know where he is. And the security guard says, well, that's because Dr. Rawson actually was the founder of and created Recoleta. And so he's in the center. He's not in the suburbs. Juan Perón is in the suburbs. And so I went to the center of the cemetery, and sure enough, there he was. You know, he's a monument to Dr. Guillermo Rawson, the founder of Recoleta, among other many other things that he did in his life. He's kind of an amazing character. And so that's the story of how the yellow fever epidemic created dancing and bordellos in Buenos Aires, the best bordellos in the world. And that's the end of this, basically, a story here. And this is supported by viewers like you who click on subscribe, become subscribers. Subscription is free. It just gives you a notification whenever I post something new. So please subscribe. That's good for me. Also, you click on the like button. And then make a comment if you have comments about anything, including the history of Argentina, whatever you want to say, say it. The more activity on this channel, the better, okay? And and then also I have a thing that puts money directly in my bank account, which is nice, so I can make money now without having to wait for YouTube to send me money. It's called buymeacoffee.com/ DERIKRAWSOR, not NR. It's a security thing. And if you click on that, you can buy me a cup of coffee like this one you're looking at here, or you can make a donation, because I'm traveling around the world telling these stories. This is better than writing books, actually. And because there are more viewers on, there are 2 billion viewers on YouTube. How many people read books? So that's the end of this episode. There'll be some end tags coming up, and you can click on those to subscribe or to go to another podcast that I've done. Podcast is shown by EP, which Easy Paul, which means episode. This is episode 35, and this is the end of episode 35. Thank you for listening. Bye-bye.